Will the TS16 content be released? I don't know what the plan is there. I will try and find out. I did promise I would find out, and I've been completely failing to do that. Hi, driver. Once the signal head clears, you'll be taking these Habins wagons south to Koblenz Lützow. If you encounter a red signal, you may have to stop and contact the signalman for permission to pass. You can do this by pressing tab on the keyboard. You're probably going to want sounds as well, aren't you? Oh, look at that lightning. Right, we've got PZBM, which is, someone remind me, 125? Ooh, lightning all over the shop. Wow. Good, headlights are okay, that's okay, that's okay. This is a Black 5. No, it's a big red box. Big red box. Gone into restricted monitoring. That's a pub. Hey, Arnold A. Schwimmer. Had epic unpredicted thunderstorms in Cornwall today. Now predicted to come and go all night. Yay. Looking forward to a good show and your Tasmara T-Race. Absolutely. I could barely hear that. Never mind. I didn't check the last signal and see what colour it was. So I'm going to have to stick in restricted monitoring and get behind schedule. That's the four signals at green. So I'm going to release from monitoring, pull and start hauling up to... Can someone remind me, is it 125? Is it 125? Thanks very much, Arnold. Sorry, I can't remember if I said that now. Thanks very much, much appreciated. Brain's clearly not working in the heat. Right, pushing on up. We've got 100 limit now anyway, so... So far, all good. Green, green. On a Black 5. No, I didn't get an answer, Francois. Apologies, I've been sidetracked on worky things. Going via Oberwinter. That isn't expecting me to acknowledge it, unless that was a repeater. Is it Darkness Monster? Not. No way. It's Darkness Monster. I'm sure that was a double yellow we just passed. Am I going colourblind? I broke the train, I think. That's better. Unbroken. Unbroken. Pete has a small white light behind it. Yeah, I know. I saw a glimpse of it out the corner of my eye, and I thought I was coming up on a yellow. But then it didn't do anything. So I wondered, I doubted myself and wondered whether or not I'd seen a yellow repeater or something. Because you don't PZB acknowledge yellow repeaters. Signals have the ability to change. I appreciate that. I didn't realise it had, though. I'm sure it was yellow as I went past it, but I'm clearly wrong, so I'm going to shut up. Either way, we're back on greens. Hey Blake Willemot, welcome back. No, I've got a pedal from the same company that make Rail Driver as the pedal for the CIFA. Shazam, it's just essentially a micro switch pedal. Oops, broke the engine. Now we got 1000 Hz. Duke of Gloucester would be awesome, wouldn't it, Flying Scotsman? It's the same, it uses the same mechanism as the as the doodad, as the smacky button. It's all via a thing called X keys. So if you Google X keys, that should take you to the website. You can get all sorts of different buttons. I've got quite a small one, but they do a big sort of 2 foot pedal, which is quite neat. And it's more the right size, actually. This is just a cheaper option. The 2 foot pedal is obviously significantly more expensive. Train Track Trav, I'm doing very good, thank you. Train Track Trav, was it you that got me Jalopy? So, before we get to the 500 Hz magnet, just before, we've gone back to green, which means I'm not going to get 500 Hz notification here. I can't speed up because it's tripped out. Right, clear the vault. Right, 60 limit from this signal or from the next one? This one, yeah, okay. A stream where it's just TPTS, I think that would drive most people a bit bonkers. It wasn't you, Train Tractor. Okay, I couldn't remember who it was. Calibration on my Rail Driver has just gone slightly out. Just enough to be hideously annoying. Frams Gelden, when are we going to see the BR86? A nice shunting scenario. It'd be nice to see a BR86 again, wouldn't it? That is actually a good shout. Yep, that's mine. That's an expect stop repeater, so I'm not expecting PZB on it. No, I'm going to hear us acknowledge just in case. Yep, it did need it. The Duchess, you won't get Tears 2017 for free. It's never been the case that content has been supplied for free. So your menu will change to show the new menu for Tears 17, but you won't get the new content. If you want the routes and trains, then you'll need to buy it. That's how it's always worked. The idea is everyone's playing the same core game, but the routes and DLC are effectively a bundle. You pick which ones you want. Should get restricted monitoring. There it goes. We've gone into restricted monitoring.
Boo.
Right. This is a perfect time for a wee bit of a tea break. Now I'm going to just have a quick look. It did say we might have to check the line ahead, and yeah, we are following a train. There it goes. Fahrmotorlüfter has kicked in. Seems like an odd way to operate a train by using a wheel. You probably find there's actually a perfectly sensible history behind it. These things don't normally happen by accident. So 40 km/h because we're in restricted monitoring. We've come out of 500 Hz. See the next signal. You know what? I'm pretty sure the signal I just passed was a green. I'll find out if I'm wrong in a minute. Garrets. Oh, garrets are lovely. Oh, I might get an emergency brake here. We'll see. Because I've acknowledged that, and I don't think I should have read up. Never mind. I thought you could end monitoring not past a VR yet. Yeah, I have a sneaky suspicion that that might actually let me get through and that's green. Oh, come on. Power's gone again. Creating our own rail driver hardware. It's actually, making hardware is a big deal. It's certainly not a trivial thing to undertake. And you almost have to think, are you a hardware company? Whereas someone like PI Engineering are a hardware company. Whereas we're not. Dovetail's a software company. So my preference is just working with people like Cytec and PI Engineering to actually create hardware. Instrument lights on. Now it looks all pretty. Running a little bit behind schedule. green with the green green. Basically means all is good with the world. Yeah, it would be good to see some new hardware, wouldn't it, Shorster? The RAR driver is okay, but it is, you know, getting old now as a piece of hardware. Technology for levers and so forth has moved on. It would be good to see someone produce something modern. Hey, Blake Willemot, cheers. See you later. Franz Gelden, you'll find out more about stuff in TS World at some point soon, I hope. That's not something I can confirm or deny at the moment. Ever attempted to build a fold locomotive cab in my living room? At the moment, I think I'd rather stay married. Did I ever publish Scrim Off changing leave usage model? No, I didn't, unfortunately, Peter J. I'm trying to... Shazen, did that fix your script, by the way? That change that we made to your script, did that fix it? Maybe you could talk to Peter J. about what you did to change the loco breakover, because I think you've got it working now. But I do have my garage, so there is always the possibility to make something more substantial in the garage. Problem is, I like to drive so many different types of loco that any cab I build would be wrong for most of the things I want to drive. Not to mention being ridiculously expensive. No, I'd rather get VR working, I think. VR is the future, I think, rather than the full-size cockpits. Mind you, it's not like VR is cheap. Ha! 500Hz magnet. Out of 500Hz magnet, but we're into, we've got 1000Hz magnet again, so I'm going to put it up a bit. MSTS Steam Controller test. Oh, is that the one I think is that what I think it is? Browsing YouTube while driving a German train with PZB. What can go wrong? What can go wrong, folks? Yeah, I've seen that. That is very, very cool. I've seen your video, Shorster. Very, very cool. Why don't I build one cockpit for each type of train? There you go. When I drive a German train, I must talk German. Oh my word. I do enough of a bad job butchering driving the German trains. You want me to butcher the language as well? Oh yeah, I've got to stop at Bad Breisig, haven't I? Thanks, Sod. What am I pulling? I'll have a look when we get out. Right, we're stopping. What have we got? Oh, we got Habins. It's a bad Habins. I am not repeating German that you guys are saying on the chat. Who knows what I could be... who knows what I could be saying? Dear, dear. Anything planned off to TSO yet? Flight sim tonight? Sure, Steve. Have you still got your controller? Because there's no reason we can't make that work with Railworks. Oh, not your video. Yeah, see you later, Shorster. Habin's only allowed to go 100, so 55. Oh, in that case, it's been set up wrong then, isn't it? So I should be on PZBU. So I've got no special monitoring or anything going on, so I can push the train right up to 120. Greens. Maricom, have I thought of doing multiplayer? In what, Maricom? In Flight Sim? I am going to at some point, but I'm not going to... not tonight. We did when I used to play Flight Sim, it was all multiplayer, and everyone got messed up and didn't like it. So I'm backing away from that idea, and I'm just going to do single player. I'm getting ready because it's the Flight Angel stream, charity stream on Saturday, and I'm taking part. And I'll be so tonight really is part of practicing for that, really. Indicator on there? No, there isn't. That's 40 I've got to get down to then. And 40 at the next one. Kaboom! Train has been rendered immobile at Andernach. You have been asked tasked with rescuing. First, Benito Wiesenthum to drop off your freight at a siding, and then you come back for the broken down train. Go and find Namdi. Not worried about that, that's not going to affect a perfect score. We're a long way from a perfect score. some Klingon. How about Tachpa, Tachpe? How about that? I believe it's Shakespeare in the original Klingon. Hey there, Nico 27B. I think Tachpe means to be or not to be. I can't remember, I was probably in Undiscovered Country. Because that was very Shakespearean. Gets accelerated. Can I at least pronounce the BR155 engine? No, I can't pronounce Bori or however that is. I've no idea how you pronounce that. What's the wheel? That's the power. It's basically the throttle control. A number of German and Swiss, various European locos use a handle, a sort of a steering wheel, circular control for the throttle. Right, so we're going up to 120. We are going via Namedy. I think there's a variable speed control adjuster over here for the wipers. Speed reduction to 110. These are implicitly Moggy approved, these wipers. They pass the standard Moggy approved test. So Moggy has announced a self-certification program where you can self-certify the use Moggy approved use of wiping by complying with a particular questionnaire and then logging the appropriate paperwork. I may not have logged the appropriate paperwork. However, the very simple test is, are you outside? Is it raining? Sorry, is it raining and are you in a tunnel? If it is raining and you are in a tunnel, Moggy approved, wiping not approved. If you are raining and outside, then Moggy approved wiping is there. Simple, really. Right, force signal is expect stop, so 1.2 kilometers, gently brake down. We're at 45 by the time we hit the 500 hertz magnet. What if the tunnel leaks water? See, that's a special case. That is a special case. Would require extra paperwork. Form 14B would need to be filled in. Right, decelerating now. Perhaps today is indeed a good day to drive, absolutely. Right, reduce speed and expect stop. Oh, by the way, I heard on my my request for partnership, unfortunately, but they did say that things are they can see that things are definitely moving in the right direction on the stream. So apply again in a few weeks' time. Can has red light. Ooh, timeliness bonus. Under 25. Remember rightly, if you're in U or M, you need to be under 25 when you hit the 500 Hz magnet, is that right? No, they're not shifting the goalposts, we're just not, the channel's just not there yet in the way they're looking at it. But we're not growing that fast. My speed. 500 Hz kicked in before we got the clear. No problem at all on the 73. It'll be ready when it's ready. 529. I'd much rather it was right than quick. Right, once the 500 Hz goes out, we're clear for 40 km/h according to the green yellow. 60 km/h apparently. Yeah, as Francois says, the goalposts are much lower than they were. That's your train on the right. Proceed to Wiesen Therme and come back for it. The old Sickerman Middle is 35. Oh, I thought they were both 25. That's interesting. Under what period is that? Is that the 14-day average, Sales UK? Hopefully over the next little while that'll go up, because last week's average was over 100. Which is rather good. So if we can keep it up this week, then hopefully we can start getting the numbers up in 3 or 4 weeks. We'll be in good shape to reapply. Alright, green with a green yellow. So we'll put it up to 75. Speed reduction down to 120, that's fine, but the green yellow implies 40 or 60. Probably 40 actually, because we're stopping at Wiesen Therme. Oh, so-and-so's. Tea time. Right. There we go. Why do they say no partnership? Just because we're not big enough yet. We need to keep we need people to keep watching the stream, keep the numbers going up, and we'll do all right. I think I let it peep up over the 75, didn't I? Yeah, that's the 14-day average. Yeah, so if the 14 days up to 88, that's looking better. That's looking much better. The Glod was already a long way away from this, Arnold, because we got a late penalty at the first one. I've had a couple of speeding penalties, so... ...40 limit as we pull in the Wiesentherm. Don't forget, on Saturday, it's the Flight Angels event, folks. Flight-angels.net, I think the URL is. Maybe one of the moderators can double-check that for me. I think I'm on 11 till 12 now, but there's stuff going on all day from midnight to midnight. So, and there are a lot of prizes. A lot of prizes, including train sim prizes, folks. Including train sim prizes. So, you want to... try and come along, support the stream, donate some money. It's all for disabled kids. Right, so we've got to drop off these cars that we wasting through them. Flightangels.com, is it, Francois? There you go. Happy Banner, I can't remember. I think Train Sim Pioneers Edition is $29.99. Am I trying to bribe you? If it means that you're going to go over to Flight Angels and give a nice donation, then I'm absolutely trying to bribe you. If that's not going to work, then no, definitely not. I wouldn't do such a scurrilous thing. Right, so we need to uncouple the Habins wagons. And go to a rival track 2. Your wagons have been dropped off. Nicely done. Quickly head over to Andernach Platform 2, where the train has broken down. You'll use the siding ahead to stop and reverse, but request permission to pass through its signal. Restrictive monitoring and a green-yellow light. I have to realise that we're a little bit lighter now, so the train's a little bit more sprightly, shall we say. Simon, putting a thing before the videos. That's not a bad shout. Now I'm doing all the videos on Vegas anyway. I can put a little clip at the front talking about the stream, can't I? Yeah, that's not a bad shout. Right, we have permission. Feel like I just need to tab it one more time. Just, you know, because I'm back. Oh, look, we've got white lights. And, Bethel 40. GWR, so the event is all day, starting midnight Saturday morning to midnight Sunday night. Like I said, mine is 11. I'm on 11 to 12, I think it is. If you go to flightangels.com and look at the schedule, you can see when I'm on, because it's marked as being sponsored by Dovetail, and I'm doing that bit. So I'm going to come back round and reverse back. Where's that train anyway? Back there at Andernach. Right. Reverse and head towards Andernach platform 1 and couple the immobile train to the rear of your loco. Obviously shrinking. Oh yes, that's the other thing. Well pointed out, Francois. If you donate a small amount, you can join in on the multiplayer session as well. We've officially passed Skibberton viewer-wise. Oh, is Steve streaming at the moment? If anyone's on there watching as well, go and send him a hi. I like Steve. Kuala Lumpur to Singapore. Yes, I should be flying a Piper Aztec. Yeah, well, we did all that. Go away. Last year's news, that is. Oh, Friday 11 is the start time, is it? Okay. It was Saturday morning, but they've obviously changed it. I know a lot of organisation going on at the moment. A lot of big names involved as well. Frugal, Nova Wing, Northern Alex is involved. There's all sorts of names. Lots of people that you'll know. Alright, now... Should I be, I think I should. Control tab. There we go. Right, we're not in restricted monitoring. We are in a 60 limit. Staying in a 60 limit. Will we see you at all at the weekend on Saturday, Amarillo? Three kilometres back to Andernach, 120 km/h. Although we're still in PZB-M at the moment. Thousand hertz, dropping speed. Small people dependent, need to pop all across Cosford. Nice, okay. Well, if you're there, look forward to seeing you. I think, if I'm understanding it correctly, how it works, the flight sim stuff, Flight Angels, is all on YouTube, and I'll be broadcasting on my YouTube channel, and then they will mirror it onto the Flight Angels YouTube. We'll find out. We're doing a test run on Tuesday. We have an approval to go through. Yes, the beta only lasts for 12 days. There are many and many, many reasons for that. Right, through there. Yeah, there are a number of reasons for it. One of them is that beyond 12 days, the feedback is quite possibly something we can't use because we just won't have time. So it's, you know, we want to get feedback on what experience people have with it, where they run it, get the feedback from it, collate that, make sense of it, work out how we're going to then do it, and then do the work. If they're feeding back for the whole 2 months, it's we can't do the feedback, which is, I think people won't appreciate if we say, here's a beta, and by the way, it doesn't matter what you say. Right, so Andernach Platform 1 is our destination. Pretty sure I'm doing this bit way too slow. Couple up to this failed train. Oh, absolutely, they do get the game to try it before release, but it won't be the finished game, so there's only so much you can get from looking at it until it's released. Train has been attached. Take this train to Koblenz, Lutzel. Right. Is that where we've got to go down to there, is it? Yep. Right, so I've got a train against us. A train behind us now. GWR, not asking for DLC, just wondering, will it be after beta that TSW gets content other than CSX? You'll have to wait until plans are announced for all that stuff, I'm afraid. Still 500 hertz. I keep using the word monitoring, I just throw the word monitoring out there, just even though it's not appropriate. Wipers. That's headlights. We have got headlights on. Train Sim 2017, I believe it's Thursday. Oh, 500 hertz is gone. Oh yeah, I've done this bit way too slow. Way too slow. Bye bye score. Good evening, Robert Lanny. Welcome. Anyone new here tonight? If you haven't pressed follow, now's the time. BMJ, you know there's only one human mod. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. You're all a good bunch. Don't really need mods. You're just all well behaved. Awesome people. Wow, I'm already 5 minutes late, even right at this minute, let alone when I'm going to get there. Should have an entire stream dedicated to the viewers asking questions to Matt that you know he can't answer. You just see how many ways you can say I can't tell you that in one evening, yeah. What and where am I flying? I'm going to be flying the Piper Aztec. I don't know where I'm going to fly yet. I might just do a little flight in the UK at the moment for today. Thursday, I might do an Embraer flight tonight and a Piper Aztec flight. Let's see how the time goes. Depends how long they take. But my Aztec is my priority because basically the goal is to actually practice using the aircraft ready for Saturday. Flying Denmark. Well, we'll see how many flights I do. We'll see how many flights I do. Right, there's track 2 south. Well, watch the score go down, folks. Watch the score go plummeting down. It's been gorgeous weather tonight, this afternoon, Chris. In fact, I'm sitting here. Oh, minus 967. I'm sitting here looking at melting in my chair, to be honest, at the moment. Rip silver. Rip bronze. Rip positive score. Rip XP. Permits. Now, I don't want to do lots of long distance flying, Ayrton. I want to practice using the ATC, taking off, landing, flying the aircraft, not just putting the airport autopilot on and having a snooze. Shazen, do you mean on Flight Angels? What is their donating site? I've not looked. But putting the autopilot on is how you fly the ERJ. Yeah, I know. No, I flew it the last time I took it out for a ride. The autopilot, the ATC and me all had different ideas of where we were going, so I disabled the autopilot and and flew the aircraft myself. SDH. The only thing that's been said at the moment is that by having access to the beta doesn't mean that you get a free copy of the game when it's released. If you look on Facebook, there was a diagram of how you get access to the beta, and it said at the bottom that it doesn't entitle you to a free copy of the beta. Oh, well, wipers can go off. Thunder but no rain. Koblenz Lützow, that is our final destination. We should already have been there 2 minutes ago. Hey Hahnemann, TS 2017 is Thursday. That's when you'll be able to buy it. Oh, this is going to hit the emergencies. Nope, this is a SPAD. On come the emergency brakes, any second now! There they go. Wow. Boom, SPAD! Oh! Beffel for you it. Yes! It wasn't as bad! Yeah, handbrake. I already put the handbrake on. That wasn't as bad. Awesome. Right, off we go. You chatty driver. It wasn't a spare. It was a red with two white dots. That wasn't as bad. And I had the Beffel alarm down at the same time. That was not as bad. Right, 1.2 kilometers. Saved by the tab. It wasn't tab. I wasn't pressing tab. It just happened. I didn't think of pressing tab. I should have thought of pressing tab, shouldn't I? I now have a 500-page document to fill out regarding my emergency braking. I'll do that at the same time as my Moggy self-certification documentation. More by luck than anything. No, I knew it was going to happen. That was exactly how I planned it to be. Should definitely have been a PZBU train though, because there's no way. I mean, I braked in advance of the yellow lights and I still had no hope of stopping, so I shouldn't be doing 120. I mean, 105 would have been pushing it, to be honest. No, in fact, even at 105, I wouldn't have been able to stop that train. So even at PZBU, I wouldn't have been able to. I would have had to have been given special instruction to run lower speed. Very well planned out. It's not planned at all. Oh dear. I did do the Beffel 40, Simon. I don't know why it didn't, but I think it was because it was in the middle of doing the emergency braking, it ignored the Beffel 40, but I was definitely doing a Beffel 40. I had the delete key down all the way through. Castle Douglas signaler? I think so. It's 25 max, Chaz, and Bethel 40 is 40. Hence the name Bethel 40. So I was probably doing over 40 as I went through, wasn't I? So the Bethel would have been ignored. So technically that was a spad then, wasn't it? Alright, fine, fair enough, it was a spad. Yeah, 155 is awesome. Koblenz Lutzor. Why is it putting the brakes on now? Was it behind me? Did I miss the stopping point? Oh well. Never mind. I still got 155 hours played. 155? What, in the 155? Wow. Anyway, moving on swiftly. Right, roads tutorial. You guys wanted a tutorial.